Welcome, everybody, to the Outlaws of Thunder Junction early access event. I'm a couple hours late getting started here because I was finishing up my limited set review for the color green. Kind of like when mom used to tell me I couldn't play video games until I finished my homework. But anyway, that set review is rolling out over at ChannelFireball.com, half written by me, half written by LSV. So be sure to go check that out. Now, as is my tradition here, I'm going to record my very first draft with the new cards for the CFB YouTube channel. So you're going to get the good, the bad, and the ugly. We'll be able to go back a couple weeks from now and laugh at some of my awful picks and misevaluations, but that's part of the fun of learning. So without further ado, let's do it. Last time, we'll show up here. You can practice. I'm going to join Premier Draft for Outlaws of Thunder Junction. So this is no sideboard, it's best of one. And let's do it. All right, friends, after quite some wait time, the draft is finally fired. So let's do it. Got the undefeated slick shot. 3 mana, 3/3 prowess. Whenever you play a multicolored instant or sorcery spell from your hand, exile it as it resolves, and it becomes plotted. So you get to double all of your multicolor instant or sorceries. Don't really know how good that is. Sharpshooter, when it becomes plotted, 2 damage to any target. So 4 mana for 2 damage plus a 3/3 reach. I like the Beast Bond Outcaster. Ooh, Ride Down, that's a fun card. Well, I think it's probably like one of the uncommons or the rare. I think I'm going to take Beast Bond Outcaster. As I said, I wrote the green portion of the limited set review, so I'm really familiar with all the green cards, and they look fun and cool. Alright, Pitiless Carnage, I'll skip that one. Fling is pretty cool. Ooh, the At Knife Point, that looked really strong, but doesn't match my first pick. That's probably pretty good, Arid Archway. Alright, I'll just take Throw from the Saddle. This looks like one of the stronger green commons. The Grizzly, of course, pairs well with my Beast Bond Outcaster, but I think Throw from the Saddle is just enough better, and we're early on in the draft. Rakdos Joins Up, a fine card. There's a world where if I had taken the red uncommon followed by the 2 red-black-gold cards, I could be on track for a pretty cool deck. Here is another shot at the Longhorn Sharpshooter. Is this Mobile Homestead a good card? It seems like it's pretty good. Could also see taking the Festering Gulch. Alright, I'll take the Festering Gulch. I changed my mind. Even if I don't go green-black, green has a lot of payoffs for having deserts, so I think I want to just spend a pick to grab that while I can. Another Throw from the Saddle, though this looks like a strong pack. The Unfortunate Accident is nice. Man, I could have just picked the black-red-gold card from every pack so far, pretty much. Search your library for basic land or a desert card reveal and put it on top. Alright, sure. Well, I'll take Throw from the Saddle over another desert. Okay, Gold Rush is really cool. I'm going to take Gold Rush. Concealed Courtyard, Fierce Retribution. Red Rock Sentinel. I'll grab the Giant Beaver, just staying on track in green, finally getting a card to pair with my Beast Bond Outcaster. All right, what's going on here? Torpor Orb is useless. Ariette the Beguiler. Whenever an aura you control becomes attached to a non-land permanent an opponent controls with mana value less than or equal to that aura's mana value. All right, well, I'm pretty far from being able to get to an Esper aura-themed card from here. Just take my green creature. I think I've made my bed and it's time to sleep in it, just taking all the green cards and trying to piece something together. Now this Bounding Felidar is quite powerful, and green and white have a little bit of a mount theme. I do have two throw from the saddles. Skullduggery is nice, but I'm looking for creatures more than I'm looking for more combat tricks. Could definitely just grab another desert. Let's try the Felidar. I think this card looks great. All right, my Drover Grizzly came around. That's a good sign for my green four power theme deck. Reach from the Sky, Wanted Griffin. I don't know, I guess I'll take Reach for the Sky. I think it's like the weakest of those cards, but I'm not super interested in moving into a new color for any of these cards. I think it's very unlikely I'll play multiple Reach for the Skies, so might as well just grab a white creature since I did get the Felidar. Okay, well, if I'm white-green and I open Mirror of the Wilds, 3-mana, 3-3 haste, non-token creatures you control have tap. Create a token that's a copy of target creature you control that entered the battlefield this turn. Non-token creatures you control have tap. Create a token that's a copy of target create a token that's a copy of target token you control that entered the battlefield this turn. What a weird card. Congregation Griffin, Flying Lifelink. When it attacks while saddled, gets +X/+X. X is the number of mounts you control, so I guess I could just build a green-white mount deck. Sure. I'm running out of time on this pick, but I'm green and white, and I see a green-white gold uncommon, so let's do it. I have double throw from the saddle, so I'll just take a bunch of mounts. Holy smokes, Vraska the Silencer, 3-mana, 3-3 death touch. Whenever a non-token creature an opponent controls dies, you may pay 1. If you do, return that card to the battlefield tapped under your control. It's a treasure artifact with treasure ability. Sure. Well, I'll probably take the Vraska. I already have a Festering Gold, so I could either go black-green, maybe I could splash the Vraska. Alternatively, Badlands Revival, return up to one target creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield. And one other permanent, so double. Wait, that's really good, isn't it? Well, I'm going to take the Vraska, but Badlands Revival is a card I'm interested in as well. Okay, Unfortunate Accident. It is double black to destroy a creature. Mourner's Surprise. The Aranx, if I'm still trying to do the mount stuff. I guess I'll just take Unfortunate Accident. Like, maybe I'm supposed to be black-green and forget about my couple of white cards. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure what direction the draft's going to take, other than that I'm green with a secondary interest in black and white. Annie joins up, enters the battlefield, it deals 5 damage to target creature or planeswalker an opponent controls. If a triggered ability of a legendary creature you control triggers, do it again. Unlicensed Hearse. Hey, I mean, that seems like a fine limited card, right? But Rictus Robber is very strong. I'm going to take the Robber over the Annie, the Hearse, the Ankle Biter, the Desert. Outcast your Green Blade. Don't mind if I do. So now another Festering Gulch or a Drover Grizzly. I think I gotta just take the Festering Gulch, especially having just picked up the Outcaster Green Blade, like on color desert when I'm trying to fix my mana. Just so good. Rush of Dread. All right. I mean, I'm getting the black cards. What do you want from me here? Ooh. As long as it's your turn, mounts and vehicles you control have hexproof. All right, well, do I commit to black-green or do I continue wavering and considering white as a second color? I think I'm happy enough with my black-green situation that I want to just take Vault Plunderer. I think this card's great anyway. Sure. Might not play the Rooftop Assassin, but I think I'll take it. Some of the Badlands Revival came around. Let's make sure I understand this. So I can return 2 creature cards from my... Oh, okay, got it. So the creature goes to the battlefield, and then any other permanent goes to my hand. I think I'm just going to take Vault Plunderer, because that card seems exceptional to me. Fine, I'll play black-green. I have no plays that I can make before turn 3. That seems like a bit of a problem. The Great Train Heist. Too much text for me to read. I have another Gold Rush. I have a Desperate Bloodseeker. I have a Spinewoods Paladin. I think I just desperately need a 2-drop creature, so I'll take the Bloodseeker. It's kind of nice with like a couple combat tricks and throw from the saddle, so... Black 2-drop it is. Might wind up with a small graveyard theme, given the colors that I am. So here's 20 cards laid out. Seems like a fine deck, just looking to fill in the two-drop spot of the curve. And there is a two-drop, the Caustic Bronco. It's a mount. It's like a Dark Confidant. It looks really nice. Villainous Wealth. Wow. That's a fun card too, but I gotta take the Bronco. Yeah, I bet LSV will record this draft for video too, so can watch two perspectives. Pitiless Carnage. I doubt I'll play that card, so we're probably on another Mourner's Surprise. Sure. Okay, Hard Bristle Bandit. That's just what I'm looking for. Man, if I was white green, but gotta take the on color two drop. That's just perfect. Surgical Extraction, a cool looking card, but extremely useless. Trash the Town's really powerful. I'll take that over another Drover Grizzly. Isn't the Centipede terrible? Why would the Centipede be terrible? Looks good to me. All right, Lively Dirge I think is weaker than the Mourner's Surprises. More interested in Desert's Dew, or yeah. I mean, just got to be Desert's Dew. Another Desert's Dew. So that's nice, filling out both the early part of my curve and picking up some additional removal spells. I'm a little heavy on non-creatures now, however. Oh, okay. I'm into the Stubborn Burrow Fiend. Little bit of a graveyard theme with the double Mourner's Surprise. I wouldn't mind another Vault Plunderer also, but just got to take the two drop, I think, given the circumstances. Another Gold Rush. I'm going to have to make some tough decisions as it regards my non-creature slots, but at least I'll have good options. All right, there's just no way I'm going to play Reach for the Sky. Last pick, Ride Down. Okay, so going to deck building here. I've got four two drops that I'm happy with. I've got basically six removal spells that I'm happy with. Hey Chase, thank you for subscribing. Welcome. I've got to make... Definitely can't play all of these non-creature cards. So I'm thinking I want to cut probably one creature and one of these other cards. The gold rushes are like kind of good in multiples, but kind of bad in multiples since they're just combat tricks. Do I have other things that make treasures? Vraska can. But if by the time that I'm making treasures with Vraska, I'm probably in pretty good shape. All right, let's just cut the gold rushes. They're cool cards, but I think it's not going to work out this time. And I have Trash the Town, which is potentially an even stronger combat trick. And then just one final cut, which could be Ambush Gigapede, Giant Beaver, Commando, Grizzly. How did I wind up on four power synergies? It's just the Beast Bond, right? The Grizzly is one of three mounts to go with Throw from the Saddle. Four mounts, I guess, with Caustic Bronco. So, Gigapede. I mean, it's probably just cut the Gigapede. I don't mind having one top-end creature, given the double Mourner surprise, but I think this is probably about where I want to be. Yep, so here's my deck, and I'll see you for round one. All right, welcome to match number one here. I'm on the draw, keep my hand, and we're off. So Rush of Dread, I basically want to set up a big board state, make my opponent sacrifice half their creatures, maybe discard some cards, maybe lose some life. All right. Well, that's scary. Enters the battlefield. You may discard a card if you do draw a card. Well, I feel a lot of pressure to block. I mean, I could take it and try to set up Rush of Dread, but if I can get away with a block here, I'm pretty happy with that. Okay. Whenever attacks while saddled, exile top card of your library until the end of your next turn, you may play that card. Okay, so I could Rush of Dread to kill two of these creatures. Or I could play a 4-4. I could play a Bandit and a Mourner's Surprise. Kind of feel like I have to Rush of Dread. So if I play a creature and it gets killed, I'm basically just going to lose. On the other hand, I could try to plot the Rictus Robber and then do Rush of Dread like a couple turns from now. Okay. Oh boy, Railway Brawler. Alright, well. Can't plot it, at least. So now I'm looking at plot the Rictus Robber and cast the Hardbristle Bandit. And next turn I'll have 7 for Rush of Dread, so I could employ 2 modes here if I want to. Oh no! They had a tapped land, so they couldn't play the Bomb Rare. Right. Well, 7 mana. Kind of want to just Mourner's Surprise and replay the Beaver. And I don't know, I'm just going to not attack. Uh-oh. Calamity, Galloping Inferno, Horse Mount. Whenever it attacks when saddled, choose a non-legendary creature that's saddled at this... What? What is going on? Create a tapped attacking creature token that's a copy of it. Boy, oh boy. Okay. I don't like anything that's going on here. I can block this and go to 1. And then Rush of Dread. Yeah, boy. Okay. So I get your card, and I get 2 of your creatures, and then I play the Rictus Robber, and hope that works out. And I get to float another mana here, so I can also play the Caustic Bronco, or... Yeah, that seems like all I can do. Do I care about making my opponent lose half their life? So that would be 8. I guess I don't have that. I don't have enough to do that. I guess I'll just kill that thing, right? Alright, can we get the one life stabilize? No deserts? Big bucks, no deserts? So we have seven. And then I can just clock for one turn. I could draw two cards. Do I care about that? I think just attack and clock for one turn. Oh, wait. Oh, no. I forgot to saddle the Bronco, so now I have to not attack with the Bronco, because otherwise I would just die. And saddle, yeah. Oops. I should have saddled the Bronco with the... Oh, it's saddle three. Yeah, probably should have saddled the Free Strider Commando. So if I give this trample, then we'd have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Sure. Whew. All right, well, that was an exciting first game of the new format. Oh boy, chat. I am against LSV. Let's see what I'm made of. I suppose the Burrow Fiend is going to be correct here, given that I do not have a 4-drop to accelerate into. Canyon Crab. It's 0/5. Beginning of your end step, if you haven't cast a spell from your hand, draw and discard. Fair enough. Hey, it's a 4/4. Still can't get through the crab, but that's pretty nice. You have plotted a slick shot lock picker. 3 mana, 2/3. Enters the battlefield, target instant or sorcery card in your graveyard, gains flashback. So, throw from the saddle. We'll kill the crab. I also have trash the town as an option. I think I'm going to play the green blade and a desert. And then crew the Burrow Fiend. I got a 5/5. Oh, Dust Animus. Well, that's brutal. I guess in theory I want to leave Throw from the Saddle as a way to fight through that, but, you know, LSV getting to have open mana and the prospect of casting Throw from the Saddle into that open mana is unexciting. Anyway... build out my board. So this can become a 2/3. No effects. You want to take 9? Fierce Retribution. Okay. Okay, well that's a useful draw. This does not have vigilance, at least. I like this Rush of Dread card. By the way, discarded Steer Clear, which is... Archive Trap me. Okay, so I'm gonna be down to 5 cards in my library. So now I could attack with my creatures, and then finish off the Dust Animus. It's honestly probably a fine choice. Oh, he's gonna flash back the Archive Trap. So I guess I'm gonna lose to just getting milled out here. Too bad. Should have taken the unlicensed hearse. Currently 1-1 after getting cheesed out by LSV. But still hoping for the best here. Pretty impressed by this stubborn Burrow Fiend, by the way. Wow, pretty lucky. Two games in a row where I'm attacking with a 4-4 Burrow Fiend on turn three. Okay, so it seems like I want to play a Desperate Bloodseeker, saddle the Burrow Fiend, and then plant a Mourner's Surprise. My best creature options are... Whoa, they took it all? The Outcaster or the Bronco? Probably the... Well, maybe the Bronco. I have plenty of lands. Alright, so Thunder Salvo just killed off my Burrow Fiend. So now it looks like I should probably just attack with my three creatures and play two more. Skullduggery would be good here. Alright, Collective Defiance, 4 damage, play a Deadeye Duelist. So Throw from the Saddle, I think, was just a lethal draw. Because it's going to give my Bloodseeker plus 1, and then present 2 lethal attackers. I had an amazing start there, and my opponent put up a good fight, almost battled back with all the removal, but just able to scrape over the finish line there. Currently 2-1 with my black-green draft deck going into match number 3. This hand is, it definitely leaves something to be desired. I don't have a great feel in this format if, keeping a hand with no play till turn three on the draw is going to be acceptable. I could, in theory, like if my opponent plays a 2-1, just cash in Morning Surprise for a 1-1 blocker. I'm gonna keep it, but this is like, I think near the bottom of the hands that I'd be willing to keep. I did find something to do on turn two, which is plot the Beast Bond. So it would be turn five before I'm able to play this for full value. I think I need to just get it out there. Just Vault Plunderer and Outcaster and try to stabilize the situation. And if I need more value, I can always replay things, rebuy things from my graveyard with the Mourner's Surprises. But right now, my priority is to make sure I survive long enough to use all my cards. The Varmint. And oh, great, another Dust Animus that I get to play against. Sure. All right, Deserts do. So that is not particularly close to killing the Dust Animus, but it's close to being close to killing the Dust Animus. What am I thinking here? Do I get in an attack of any kind? Yeah, I probably want to start attacking so that I can get my creatures back with Mourner's Surprise. So I attack you with both, and I hope you choose to block something. Well, this is really all I can do. If I block nothing, I take 13 damage because this does have double strike. And then I'm almost certain to die the following turn to the Dust Animus. Looks to me like I need to trade off here. Because then I'll go to five and I can, in theory, survive one hit from Animus. Sure. All right, a little help here. That is some help. All right, I guess I'm just going to pass. Yep. Okay, well, this is definitely happening. Then we have eat this. Trade with the stagecoach. Unless, is there something that I specifically want to go to my graveyard for the mourner's surprise? Probably be the beast bond. But yeah, I mean, I guess this is fine. Resolve first strike damage, resolve regular damage. I would love to get back that Vault Plunderer, but can't really afford to, because I'd have to target my opponent with the ability, and that's awful. So I think it's just land go. So whenever a mount or vehicle you control attacks, put a +1/+1 counter on it. It does not have to be saddled. So chumping and double blocking. That ain't good. I just need to cast this. Well, block, block, right? Does it matter who I mill? Go for mill you. Alright, so I can pump the Bloodseeker attack, gain 3, but it does both leave me vulnerable, and it means my opponent can choose to draw a card with the Outlaw Medic. If they get a crime, I'm dead, but if they get a crime, I'm in chump block mode anyway. So I'm not loving this situation. I think I'm gonna go for it. I just have to hope my opponent doesn't really find anything. All right, a little help here. That's some help. This is nice for the Outlaw Medic. Can get some value there. So many turns played at one life in so far in this draft. Two life in this case. So I'm going to have to block this with Vraska and something else. Basically trading the Vraska for it, because otherwise it's chumping or dying, so... All right, creature off the top. Let's go. Huh. Well, that's kind of interesting. I mean, it's very interesting. However, I can't really just attack with the Bronco because I risk dying. I actually think I'm supposed to just pass and try to use this on defense. Ooh. Death by Armadillo. So I do have to block both. And then just give 2 counters to the Bronco to win in combat. I could also... Like, you can target your opponent's stuff, so I could have the medic deal me 1 damage and then draw me 2 cards. So I want to give two counters to my Bronco. I want to give trample to your medic. And I want the medic to draw me two cards. Oh, wait. Target creature gains. Okay, so that's not going to work. That's not going to work. Because it would give the... It wouldn't just be me drawing two cards. It would give my opponent's creature the ability. So I think my best bet is just to give two counters to my Bronco and call it a day. I'm not sure if I understood that correctly. Somebody in the Twitch chat or the YouTube comments can let me know if there's more to it. Well, I mean, this looks like it's going to be cool, but it's actually not really going to be that helpful because my opponent's just going to keep the armadillo and then I'm going to have to chump block with my Bronco. Still alive. Unfortunately, I think a lot of my best draws are no longer in the deck. Like, what I would really need is Mourner's Surprise. That's not going to work out. Okay, I am defeated. Two and two. So facing elimination, and I have quite the end boss here. This is Numot the Nummy. I always lose to Numot in these early access events, but maybe this will be the time that I finally get him. Well, I think it's Bronco. Milled a hard bristle bandit of my own. Okay, so assuming my opponent is going to play a big creature and then a beast bonder, I mean, I could leave up Unfortunate Accident, but then it's just really bad if my opponent sees through that and chooses to spend their mana on something else. So alternatively, it's like just play the beaver or Mourner's Surprise the Bronco and replay it. But then I probably won't be able to kill all the blockers. So I think I've decided to just play the beaver. Alright, so more plotting. Could just get in for six and pass with unfortunate accident, but that's not my choice here. Saddle up. Surveil to the top. So I'm kind of hoping my opponent spends their mana on something so that I can feel comfortable just casting throw from the saddle and not getting blown out. But I guess there's a lot of things that can happen here. Alright, I'm thrown from the saddle. Well, I got my wish that I get to cast my spells in the way I want to. All right, I don't really see any other way than throw from the saddle, Bronco, and Paladin, and then attack with Bronco for full value. And then I could use Unfortunate Accident, but I think I'd rather just play Rictus Robber. Save this for my opponent's next big creature. So now the hope is that my opponent just plays one big blocker. I kill it, and then all my creatures can attack. Now, that is one big blocker. It does have Ward 3, so I have to spend 7 mana to kill it. I do have that much. And then, assuming my opponent's going to trade with the Bloodseeker, it's best for me to give extra power to Rictus Robber. There's almost no way they're going to choose to block that. Ouch. So I can attack with a 5-2 trample, which does seem worthwhile. Yep. So play the Vraska, make this attack. And I get a treasure for my troubles. Plotting the Beast Bond Outcaster. So not just casting it outright to trade with the Vraska. That is interesting. Almost could be lethal with the Vault Plunderer, but not lethal enough. Gotta just plot this, I guess. Oh, nice draw. Okay. So casting. I think it probably is time to trade the Vault Plunderer, because then if my opponent doesn't find anything, they have no realistic blocks against these two creatures. So yeah, if I attack with both, my opponent is basically going to lose all three creatures. So then I have to choose between, do I want to just play a 3-3 and give my opponent one draw step to find an answer? Or do I want to get the max value of trying to make it a 5-5? I think I'm just going to play it as a 3-3 and make the game so that if I ever have more creatures than my opponent on the battlefield, I'll win. Hey, I beat Kenji for once in my life. And I get to live to fight another day. And I'm back, currently 3-2. On the draw with my black-green deck. A nice hand here. Been really impressed with this stubborn Burrow Fiend. I've also been impressed with Rush of Dread. There have been a couple games where it didn't save me, but powerful card, I think. Just casting Aloe Alchemist. All right, what's my plan? Well, I think whether I'm trading or not, it almost has to be correct to play the Burrow Fiend. And I suspect that it is going to be in my best interest to trade. This thing just hits a little too hard. My opponent's on the play. On the other hand, I could let the battlefield get set up a little bit and then play the Rush of Dread. All right, I block. My priority is to make sure I have the Vraska on the battlefield at whatever time I choose to cast the Rush of Dread. So I'm thinking there's some likelihood where I just go Vraska, then turn 4 Hardbristle Bandit, and then turn 5 play the Rush for 6 mana. Oh wow, cool. You get 5 lands over the course of 5 turns. They have to have different names, though. Four lands. All right, sure. I'm on the bandit plan. So I can get one card from hand and one creature. I kind of like Mourner's Surprise into Vraska to reset that up. There's a world where I can steal the Varmint as a treasure and then disenchant the Omen Path. But actually what happened is my opponent used Savage Smash, which is a fight, and since Vraska has Death Touch, it worked out more or less okay for me. So one creature and half your life. Guess I gotta start here. Oh, nice. So pump this and then play the Beast Bonder. This thing's scary, though, because, you know, attack and then ping my best creature. Wow, Dance of the Tumbleweeds after the Omen Path journey. That is a 9/9 creature. There's no arguing that. So now, half your life, two of your creatures, you keep the 9-9, you're at 8. Still no great attacks available to me, so maybe I'm just playing the beaver and waiting one more turn. If my opponent, for example, attacks with the 9-9, then it will be tapped, and then I play the Rush of Dread, and it's a choice between do you want to die outright, or do you want to sacrifice your best creature to leave an untapped blocker. Well, now it's time. All the modes. Do I have enough? Yeah, I think I have exactly enough. And then block the biggest, and 8 damage gets through. Welcome back. 4-2 with my Golgari draft deck, so I've officially won more than I've lost. That's a good feeling. So play the Bronco, then play the Plunderer, and hope to be able to attack. There's also some world where my opponent will have a blocker, and I'll choose to use Throw from the Saddle or Trash the Town. But the Bronco is just a really powerful creature to have on the battlefield on turn two. Question in chat, if you target two different creatures with different parts of a spree card, does it count as two crimes? No, I think one spell or ability is only ever one crime, even if it targets multiple things. Hey, my caustic Bronco. Well, seems like only one thing to do here. I think my opponent did the thing that I forgot that I did earlier, which is forgetting to saddle during your first main phase. So I guess I dodged 3 damage there. Okay. Well, part of me wants to kill the Griff. Part of me wants to just plot the commando. I wonder if there's any world where I attack here. No. So, gotta hope that the 5/5 ground creature can stabilize. That's complicated by this Sterling Keykeeper, but can still buy me a bit of time. Yeah, I'm hoping to draft a second time after this one. Alright, well that's bad, because now I'm looking at a lot of scary first strike damage against my 3-1s. Gonna block just the Keykeeper, take 7, and then yet another game where I'm sitting around at 1 life. I can mill my opponent. They did scry to the top, for what that's worth. Now I can either put 2 counters on one of my creatures, or I can Desert's Dew for -2/-2. Alright, well, I get to win combat with a 4/4 lifelinker, which will mean I'm no longer at 1 life, hooray! But I'm still definitely not in great shape. Hey, Alamora, thank you for the sub. Haven't seen you in a long time. Welcome back. Oh. I'm gonna level with you. I did overlook that ability of the Cacarantula. So giving my opponent a free card there is not great. If my opponent blocks with everything, I guess this goes badly for me. Is that realistic that they would choose to do that? I think I'm gonna gamble. Just, I think I have to put this in combat and hope something works out for me. My opponent got priority there, so hopefully they're just doing an arena bluff where they put it into full control mode. I feel like this is the type of game where you want to just make plays that look good on the board and not overthink yourself playing around stuff. My opponent is deep in the tank here. Which I don't blame them. It's like, do you want to double block, take your medicine, and trade against the lifelinker? Or do you want to, you know, not block and hope something good happens off the top? Man, just call me the comeback kid. I keep fighting back from these one life situations. So there's a few ways that I could play this, but I think I certainly want to saddle the Burrow Fiend. Let's start there. Honestly, like, I could just play the Rictus Robber, use that to saddle, and then pump the 2-3 to get in. Could have chosen to pump the Burrow Fiend. Still going. All right, friends, 5-2. I'm on the play with a hand where it's basically just, if I hit my third land on turn three, it's very good. If I don't, I'm in trouble. 15 lands and 33 cards, so it's like pretty close to, you know, 70 to 75% that I'm going to hit my third land on time. I do have two enters the battlefield tapped lands, which complicates things a tiny bit. This is like a straight up good hand if I hit my third land. It's got the removal, it's got a couple above rate cards, so I think I'm gonna keep it. Okay, I've done it. So I can, unfortunate accident, just make a 1-1 mercenary, but I'm not planning on doing that. Whenever you cast your second spell each turn, create a 1-1 red mercenary. Let's try to get some value from these Vault Plunderers before there's an army of 1-1s that make it impossible to use them. Okay, so my opponent's gonna go Wolverine and another spell and have a 1-1. So the Vault Plunderers are not gonna be... Oh, I mean, I guess the second Vault Plunderer is still fine. Alright, sure, I'll play a Vault Plunderer. Okay. So, I think I like... Vraska, attack with both, and then throw from the saddle the Gila Courser. Whoa, isn't this card really strong? Holy smokes. Okay. So be it. Oh, I forgot about the paying one extra with Vraska. Okay, that was less than ideal. Thank you. Getting to steal the Wolverine with Raska is kind of cool. I'll try to do that in the end step. Okay, but it's not until the next end step, it's just until end of turn. That's unfortunate. This has been a challenging game to navigate so far. All right, saddle up. Or maybe not even saddle, maybe just attack. Okay. So my opponent has shrunk my grizzly, attempted to block with the Wolverine. Now I'm trying to kill it with unfortunate accident. If that works, I get to Vraska it and maybe get a card off my library. This has definitely been hard, like my opponent having all their mana open every turn and just having to guess what they might have, especially not being super familiar with all the instants and sorceries available in the format. Okay, so we're in combat right now, which means nothing more to be done. And I guess I'll plot this. Flying haste. Whenever you cast your second spell each turn, investigate. Wow, that is powerful. All right, I think I'm just putting all my power and toughness onto the battlefield now and trying to make a big trampling attack next turn. Because I'm not going to win. If the game goes like two or three more turns, I'm either going to die to the flying creatures or I'm going to die from getting valued with my opponent's, you know, all my opponent's synergies. So I think the best I can do is just put a bunch of creatures onto the battlefield, give them trample, and hope it's enough. Whenever you cast your second spell each turn, 2 damage to the opponent and you scry 1. So maybe if I draw, like, the Rush of Dread or Throw from the Saddles, you know, something to remove the Pulverizer. So I don't really want to make a non-lethal attack with the Grizzly. I think the best I can do is attack with 5-3 Rictus Robber. Oh no! So another spell here, that's 4, plus 4 in the air, plus the mercenaries, that's a good game. So it looks like I'm going to have to settle for 5-3 with this Golgari draft deck. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're sticking with me live on stream, I'll be doing another draft. And for the rest of you, thanks for watching.